Hi, thanks again for watching 1MinuteDigital.com. Today is a little bit longer tutorial today for those of you who are interested in learning how to design and save your file for a printer, a business card. And I'm going to be working a little bit in Photoshop, but mostly in Illustrator to show you how to prepare your card. You have a business, you need a business card, maybe you don't have a logo yet, but you can still make a really nice looking business card with just a photo and a little bit of type manipulation. So the few things that I want you to keep in mind are here on the screen. Use a high resolution image that's 300 dpi or more for your printed card and make sure it's CMYK. Outline your fonts, make sure to add bleed if it's a full bleed image, and don't use more than 1 to 2 fonts. That's more a design tip than printing. But these are the things that printers will look for, and if you don't have some files prepared correctly, they're going to ask you to redo them, resend them, or they're going to fix them the way they think they should be done. So here we go. From start to finish, we're going to design a business card and get it ready for print. Okay, first thing, in Adobe Illustrator, go to File, New, and you have the option here for number of artboards. We can have as many as we want. We only need 2 because we want the front and the back of the business card. Your file size is going to be 3.625 by 2.125. Oops. Because business card size are 3.5 by 2, but when they have bleed, they need to be a little bit bigger so the edge, as you can see here, gets cut off. And the artwork needs to go all the way to the edge so that when they're cutting, if it doesn't go all the way to the edge, you might have a white line at the edge, which looks really, really bad. So we want to make sure our file size is a little bit bigger than the actual printed size. Say OK. And now we have 2 artboards, the front of the business card and the back. If you go to Window, Artboards, you can see them here, Artboard 1 and Artboard 2. So keep this palette open while you're working. Now, for the front of the business card, we're going to use a photograph, that cupcake photo that I showed you in the earlier screen. Let's open up that image. I downloaded that image, the cupcake image, from morgfile.com. It's a great place for free stock photos. So let's go ahead and open that image that I got. It was a JPEG. And here it is. It's a cute little image. If you go to Image Size, you can see it's 34 inches wide by 45 high, but it's only 72 dpi. For printing, your resolution of your Photoshop images needs to be 300 dpi. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. You need to have a high resolution image for that. So making sure none of these options here are checked, go ahead and highlight that 72 and change it to 300. And you can see the width and the height changed. It went down to about 8 by 10 now instead of that huge image. It's going to make it smaller, but that's still much, much bigger than we need for a business card. So say OK. Now go to Image, Mode, and change it from RGB to CMYK. That's what it needs to be for printing. Say OK. And now we're going to save it. Save as. I'm going to call this Cupcakes. And save it as a TIFF file. This is the best to use for printing. I mean, if you saved it as a Photoshop or a JPEG, it's really not the end of the world, but you really need to save it as a TIFF for printing. So now it's cupcakes.tiff and save it. Okay, so we're done with that one. Going back to Illustrator. Let's place our image that we want to use first off. So you're on the first artboard, which is artboard number 1, the front of the card. Let's move it over. Go to File, Place. Now search wherever it is on your desktop in a folder where you just saved that photo. It's Cupcakes TIFF, Place. And see, it's much, much bigger than we need, and it's a high resolution image, so it's great. So let's, holding down Shift, click on the corner and drag that down until it's about the size of our business card. Now the next thing we need to talk about is bleed. This document is sized a little bit bigger than a business card. Remember, it's 3.625 by 2.125. What you should do as you're working is click on your rectangle tool here, click anywhere on the artboard, and make a 3.5 by 2 size rectangle. Click OK. Now using your selection tool, move that right into the center of your business card. Go down to here to your swatches palette, click on the white part here, and click on this red slash. It's going to get rid of the white part of that rectangle and just leave you that stroke, the black outline. I want that there because I want you to see how big you have to make your image so that it bleeds outside of the business card, because it's going to be cut there. And if we don't have our image extending all the way, when it cuts, it could leave a white line at the edge. You don't want to do that. So you need to make sure that you see the area that you're working with, that you can't go outside this area with your type or your picture, and that's really going to help you later. So put that in the center. Now copy that, edit copy, and edit paste. And the new one, just grab it and move it over to your second artboard. So we have that there as well when we work on the back. So this is the bleed area outside of this black rectangle. Okay, so we have our image, we have our rectangles here. Now we need to design the rest of our business card. So let's just say the name of this company is 1 Minute Bakery. You just use your type tool and type it. Get your selection tool, grab it, bring it down. Let's pick a nice font for that. So go to Window, Type, Character. If you use this window, when you click on the name of the font, you'll get a preview of all the fonts in the actual style that the font is in. If you go up to here, the character palette on your toolbar, it does not show you a preview, so that's kind of boring. You don't get to see what it's going to look like. So if you click on your word, go over to your character palette, and then you can play with it and see what they look like before it changes. It helps you decide what font to use. So I'm going to go ahead and use Pacifico. And now holding down Shift, hover over it till you get those arrows and pull it out till it gets to be the size you want. I think that looks good. 1 Minute Bakery. Now let's have a tagline for our business. How about just using the type tool, click anywhere. Here is fine. Let's call it, just start typing, it doesn't matter, cupcakes on the go. Now I assume you have all of your words written. I'm just sort of making this up as we go along. Now for the tagline, we don't need it to be in the same font as the logo type. So let's select that and go over again here to our character palette. If it's gone, make sure you go to Window, Type, and Character. But it is here. And let's change that to a little bit easier to read font for smaller type. How about I like Arial. Where is Arial? Where are you? Where are you? Arial Narrow and Italic. That's going to be our tagline. I'm going to put that underneath. I think it's a little bit big. Let's make it smaller up here in the toolbar. You can just go ahead and click the arrow down until it gets to be a good size for a tagline. Then just grab it, move it over there. It looks pretty good. Now, go over back to your type tool and click and drag and make a nice box here. And now you're just going to start typing all your information. You probably have this already. I'm just going to make this up. Joan Smith is the owner. And the phone number is area code 123-123-4567. The her email address is joan@oneminutebakery.com. And the website is www.oneminutebakery.com. And the address is 1234 Main Street. If you hit option and the number 8, you get a bullet point, space, your town, USA, and 12345. Okay, so now we have all of the information that we need in our business card. So we still have the selected, and now it's time for a little bit of styling. I think this is a little bit big for the text box. We're going to go ahead and make that smaller, so you just hover over there and select that bottom address, and let's make that maybe 8 points, and that should fit very nicely, maybe even 8.5. We don't want to make it too small. Never go below 7 point, that's too small. Now I think it all fits, but let's start at the top. So 1 Minute Bakery, it looks okay in black, but maybe we want it pink to kind of match this the color in this photo. So over here on your toolbar, go find your eyedropper tool. It looks like the little eyedropper. And anywhere you select in here, it's going to sample that color. There's the brown of the chocolate, the white of the coconut, and the pink of the tablecloth underneath it. I think that looks good for the logo type. So there we go. We have 1 Minute Bakery. It almost looks like a logo. And when you center it, keep in mind you're not centering it to this edge because this edge is going to be cut off. You're going to center it in this triangle here to the edge of your photo. So give it a good amount of space between. That looks good. How about the tagline? Cupcakes on the go. I think it maybe should be gray. So double click on your fill palette with it highlighted. Pick a nice gray color. Okay. And that looks good. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. With that selected, hold down shift and drag this out. And that looks a little bit bigger. It stands out a little bit. It's different from the main type and it looks like a tagline. How about though, if we make that all caps, go to type, change case, uppercase. I like it better in all caps, but maybe not so big. So holding down shift, move it again. And there we go. There's our tagline. Now let's style the rest of it. It's a little too close to the top. Let's move it down a little bit. Let's highlight Joan Smith and let's make it the same as the tagline. So using your eyedropper tool again, with that highlighted, just select that and it's going to go ahead and change it to the same font size and font as the one you just selected. I like that, but maybe we should make it bold. So it's Arial narrow, italic, we're going to make it bold italic. And maybe 2 points bigger up here. There we go. And for owner, that's fine underneath, phone number. Let's give it a little bit of space. So go ahead and highlight that. Go over to your character palette. And this is your letting setting here, the two A's on top of each other. Just give it a little bit of space. Click the arrow up, up, up. Maybe 3 times is fine. And also with the address, let's go ahead and select that. Go over here to your letting and up, up, up. It just separates those a little bit, gives a little bit of breathing room. Now kind of make sure it's centered. Move it a little bit where you want it. And I think that looks really nice. There we go for the front. Okay, so moving to the back, just hold down your space bar, get your little hand and move it over so you can work with it here. I think we're going to make the background pink for this one, full bleed pink card. So using your rectangular tool, just click and drag. It doesn't matter how far out you go, but you only need to go about that far. Using your eyedropper, select that pink area again and go to Object, Arrange, Send to back. Okay, now there's our area, our pink area, full bleed all the way to the edge. Now, what are we going to put on the back? That's up to you. I'm going to go ahead and make something up. So using your type tool, click and drag, and we're going to say best cupcakes in town, open 7 days a week, and visit our website. www.oneminutebakery.com. Now we have all this formatted to flush left. We want to make it centered. So with all this still selected, just go use your selection tool, the black arrow. Go up to the top here. You can see there is flush left, centered, and flush right. You want to make it centered. And now if you hover over this bar and you drag it all the way to the edge, it will make sure that it is in exactly the center. I think we can make that a little bit bigger. Here in the character palette, also increase the letting, give it more space between the lines. And I think we'll go ahead and highlight this website address. And over here on our color palette, let's make that white so that pops out. Now this is the same font that we used for our information over here, our owner information. It's good. A design tip is don't use too many fonts. I know it's tempting to go ahead and use every font you have in your character palette, but it looks really nice and professional when you only use one or two fonts. And so what we have is the entire thing is in this Arial narrow, except for this logo type, which is in Pacifico. And I think that looks pretty good. Now we have the front and the back. So what you do to get this ready for print is first thing, delete these rectangles that you made. Just select them, delete, select, delete, because you don't need them to be there. Otherwise they will print. So make sure you get rid of those. Now we're going to select all, which is Command A or Object or File. I don't know, I use key commands so much I don't remember. Select all, Command A, and that selects everything. Now go type Create Outlines. That turns them from fonts into graphics. So now there are no fonts embedded anymore. It has changed them to a graphic. Now, you want to go to Window Links. And it shows you any links you have in your file. In this case, we only have an image that is linked here that was not created in Illustrator. It was created in Photoshop and linked here. We need to embed that image because we're going to send it to a printer who doesn't have this on his desktop. He only has it in the file. So on your links palette, click on this little arrow up at the top and say Embed Image. And that's going to make sure that image stays in there forever and never leaves. Okay, now we have it. Let's go ahead and save it. Sorry, too many key commands. File, Save As. And let's call this Business Card Print. Save it as a PDF and save it where you want it. Now here in Illustrator, in the Adobe PDF preset, you want to click there and select Press Quality. Uncheck Optimize for Fast Web View, but leave Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities checked just in case your printer needs to go in and move something. You just never know when they're going to have to do something, and if this is checked, they'll be able to do that. Under Compression, make sure it is not downsampled. Do not downsample. You want to make sure it stays at high resolution. And say Save PDF. And now if we open it in Adobe Acrobat, we open that B-card print. There it is, our beautiful high resolution image. And if you look here on your page thumbnails, it is not one but two files, front and back. And this file is absolutely print ready, CMYK, outlined fonts, embedded images, and it's ready to send to your printer. And that really is the best way to do it, to do a full color business card. One thing I didn't mention is you should always save a copy of your layered file before you do all the outlining and embedding. So make sure to save a copy as a layered file. So if I do Command Z, undo, we can do File, Save As, and call it Business Card Layered, just to save a copy that you can go in and easily edit and keep that as an Adobe Illustrator file and save that in your folder, just in case your phone number changes later or something changes where you have to go in and edit it. You don't have to retype everything. So there you go. That is the best way to get your files print ready and printed. I hope this was helpful. I know it was a long one for me, but thanks so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.